Umar used to come here, and because everybody know that he has attitude problem, so we were kind of withdraw ourselves from him. So he will only come just participate in that Arabic part, which is standing, bending, and prostration, and then he will leave.
We were pretty much in shock at first. We didn't really believe that it actually happened. Like, this is like someone who used to, like, just like that we knew from around here.
Allah.
Every imam will be in this position in the future because mosques are open public places. Hundreds of people come, we don't know their action, what they watch on the internet. If suppose there is an extremist imam who is promoting violence, everybody know about him right away. So as far as we here in Fort Pierce are concerned, we always very conscious, consciously speaking about peace, about love, about unity. We came to this country gave us everything. And this is against the Islamic law, that you get benefit from a community, from a country, and then you are doing conspiracies against it. Before, it was absolutely open. We never questioned who you are. But now when we see some brand new person coming, so we just take him to the side. We say, how are you, brother? Who you are? We are more cautious. In Ramadan, the people are more connected to God, and they pray a lot. And the spiritual power and the spiritual force is the one that you combat with situation like this. So personally, I think, and when I look at the people, that they are coping with this tragedy much better. My message to the Muslim is that if we are, this is a free country, and this is the land of rule and regulation. You are not guilty, you don't need to be scared of anybody. And if you see anybody who is suspicious, you think he will cause trouble for you and the whole community, don't feel mercy in reporting.